Tonight is a really special night. I would love to have my brother Lauren come up here and share a few things from his heart.
Well, guys, thank you so much for coming on tonight. I don't have a lot to share per se. The day and age that we're living in and the challenges that plague various communities. And I'm so honored to stand with Justin Haley, this organization that has started this campaign to address racism, not only again here in obviously California, but across the world. Mm-hmm. And I'm so honored to have a moment just to share some of my thoughts as it relates to, you know, racism. I've realized in my own personal life that how important love has been able to open doors. It's been able to navigate multiple terrain, understanding, forgiveness, when really my response should have been that of hate. My response is that of forgiveness and love and understanding. And I've seen how, you know, that type of love has covered and addressed a multitude of sins. It's been able to open doors. I wanted to see if this gentleman would have a moment of coming up. Louis, are you here? Can you come on up?
Yep.
Thank you for being here, brother. We really appreciate you. Thank you for bringing your family.
Yes, sir.
Wow. I don't know if there's many times that I'm lost for words, but I'll simply just share what's on my heart. I'm a black man, as you can obviously see, because you can't see me. But here's the real catch to that. I'm gonna back up and get near some light so you actually might see. But this is what it's like to live in this world. The invisible man. My great-grandmother, Ma Beulah, used to sit on the front steps chewing tobacco and would spit and a switchblade at her breast. And she looked at me at 16 and she said, "Louis, don't you ever bring me no white girl home." And I said, "Ma Beulah, I don't understand why." And she said, "Because I said so." So I was perplexed by that. So I went to my mom and I said, "Mom, Ma Beulah just spoke something I never heard my family speak of race." Long story short, my Ma Beulah had been raped by her master. My grandmother was the recipient of that. And therefore my great-grandmother thought that that was the way of life. I'll never forget my response to that. And that was, "Ma Beulah, I can't embrace your hate." I've spent my life not embracing that hate. I've spent my life really looking for the opportunities to serve. And I joked openly by saying, "You can't see me," but actually some days I can't be seen. There's some days I walk and jog in the communities I live in, gated community, might I add, and say good morning every morning, only to get no response.
Wow.
But that's okay. Because when you understand who you are in God's eyes, and you choose love in spite of a response, you watch these little moments shift. And why I'm so encouraged by what you're doing tonight, Justin, is this. If you notice, when the guys started hitting the band and the music started pumping, there was no words. Mm-hmm. But every heart in here responded to the sound. That's what humanity is. It's a response to the heart. It's not the skin. It's not the DNA. And music has a way of shifting the words that we can't find adequately enough to share. And what's interesting about this time in history is that it's your generation that will have a very different conversation with your children and your grandchildren. And it won't be, "Don't bring that home," but "Welcome home." Welcome home to love and possibilities. You stand on one of the most significant stages in the world. And that is the stage of music. The stage of influence. The stage of possibilities. The stage of grace. The stage of power. And we have the power in the room And if you don't believe me, try me. You have the power in this room to change humanity.
Yes, sir.
That's the power that's in this room. Think about that. You have the power to light a fire that changes culture, that makes people change their perspective about humanity. And that's what this is. So when I was talking with Justin just the other night, which was so beautiful, and he was sharing his heart, and he's like, man, if you just, you know, if you got a second, just come share. I'm like, I'm there. It's easy. Why? Because my entire life has been built around building relationships. Don't let anybody minimize your dreams about changing culture for the good. Don't let anybody shrink your imagination just because of your age. You are the leaders of tomorrow. Recognize. I love your shirt. Racism is evil. That's true. As y'all would say, that's facts, right? I got you. So anyway, bless you guys. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. Take full advantage of being something different than what they could have ever imagined. Yes. And that is walk in peace and love.
Let's go.
Amen.
For the ghost of you, I miss you more than life.